David Hynes, head of the AIA, the executive director, with us for a couple of minutes. The governor not addressing high school athletics to this point, is that making your life more difficult?
Well, we have gone with the philosophy with the board and our staff that we are really tied to in-person learning. When the governor allows in-person education to take place is kind of our target on when we can get back to activity.
Focusing on football, what will Friday nights look like, assuming you can have games this fall?
Well, we would really like to just get back to practice before we even get to games. Games right now, we're not even talking fans in the stands. Again, that will be more of a discussion with the governor's office and probably the individual county health departments on where they are at the time in their areas.
Travel. So I look at games right now and I see week one, if it is September 11th, Boulder Creek going down to Castile. I see Hamilton and Centennial. Later, I think it's Liberty and Queen Creek. A lot of miles for kids being on buses. Has there been given any discussion of reworking schedules to just make it within a certain mile area?
All of those things are being considered, Brad. When we're looking at schedules, we have reenacted the football reclassification committee that looked at all this rescheduling on things that how we would do it. How many games are we going to play? Mm-hmm. Will we use a rating? Will we use the decision by the conferences to modify the playoff? So all those things are in play. Depending on which way we want to go, we can adjust schedules.
So there is consideration to taking what is presently out there and saying, this isn't happening. We've never been in a pandemic before. We'd rather have a school play a school 2 miles away rather than 60 miles away.
We've had all kind of discussions based on, you know, what option we end up being able to do. We want to have our kids at least have the opportunity to participate, you know, in their sports without losing what we did last year in the spring. Mm-hmm. Again, nothing that we have is off the table at this point. We just are monitoring, adjusting, looking at plans, looking at different things, and involving a lot of people in the decisions that we'll end up making by the governing board.
Okay, before I get you out of here, what can you say to the schools that have not touched a football? So I'm hearing from a lot of them in Tucson and Phoenix Union in regards to having a season. Will there be a season? Will it be leagues within schools right near one another? That may address the previous question I asked you. But what do you say to those schools that haven't touched the ball at all, David, at this point?
Well, and I understand that. We have some schools that have been doing some workout. There are probably fewer schools that are doing a lot of work. A lot of people are doing work on their own or working with groups of people that are not necessarily affiliated with the schools. I would say we're going to be old school. Back when I coached and when I played, we did not have access to our kids or our coaches during the summer. Practice started on the first day of practice. And so you had, you know, 3 or 4 weeks to get ready for the first game, your season, whatever we played.
Will there still be open division this year?
We are planning to still have an open division.
Will there be any impact on winter or spring as you sit here today?
We are hoping that we do not go into the winter season, that we can make adjustments and without going into the winter. Depending how far we have to get pushed back, one of our options would be to take whatever's left of the fall, take whatever the winter season is, add those weeks together and divide in half and give each of them an equal number of weeks. That is a possibility too.
David, I appreciate your time. That phone's got to be ringing a lot more. I'll let you go off that. Thanks.
All right. Thank you so much, Brad.